Hi everyone, my name is Charles Wall, and I've been asked by the church to read a couple of verses of scripture to kick off our Lent through the Lens series. The two verses I'm going to be reading are taken from Matthew's Gospel, chapter 5, verses 3 and 4. Those of you that know your Bible will immediately recognize them as the first two Beatitudes that Jesus used to teach his disciples on the mountainside when he was preaching. So what are Beatitudes? Well, they are the well-known verses that all start with, blessed are. The noun, beatitude, refers to a state of great joy. Blessed. The noun, beatitude, is blessing or great joy. Or as I saw it on the internet recently, not beatitude, but the happy attitudes. So let's start by looking at Matthew chapter 5, verse 3. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Now, you, like me listening to this piece of scripture, might be at a loss to fully understand what the words mean. And I don't think we're alone. One of the followers of Billy Graham, the famous Christian evangelist, said to Billy, after hearing this beatitude, "Hey, Billy, what did Jesus mean by we ought to be poor in spirit? Shouldn't we be rich in spirit?" Billy Graham brilliantly responded in the following way. What he meant is simply this. We must be humble in our spirits. If we put humble in the place of the word poor, you would understand what he meant. So let's reread that again, substituting humble for poor, and see if we understand it any better. Blessed are the humble in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. In other words, when we come to God, we must realize our own sin and spiritual emptiness and poverty. We must be self-satisfied or proud in our heart, thinking that we don't need God. If we are, God cannot bless us. The Bible tells us that God opposes the proud, but he gives grace to the humble. In Matthew's Gospel, Jesus warns his disciples not to be showy like the priests who strut about in their fine garments with long fringes, longing to be noticed, taking the best seats in the house and chanting long prayers in the temples, trying to impress others. No, he teaches his disciples to be humble, to be like servants. And he demonstrated this, if you remember, by washing their feet. So I'd like to just share my own version of this first beatitude. There is great joy for those who are humble, for they will have a place in heaven. So let's look at the second beatitude found in chapter 5 and verse 4. And it says, blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Again, that's a bit of a curious beatitude. Now, I've been learning French for a number of years, so I read a chapter of French from a French Bible each morning trying to learn the language. And I remember a few weeks ago, I read this beatitude, and I think the version I read in French was a little bit more understanding. So I'll read it to you, and I'll just translate it as I read it. Heureuse, happy, les affligés, are the afflicted, car, because, ils seront, they will be, consolés. So, heureuse, les affligés, car, ils seront consolés. Happy are the afflicted, they will be consoled, because they will be consoled. So good news, great news, God will console those who are afflicted. Some biblical scholars say that the morning that Jesus is talking about here may not be about the mourning as we come to understand it, associated with death and loss of a loved one, but he is speaking about the deep sadness that some Jewish people experienced when the Jewish nation turned away from God and turned to sin in days gone by. Jesus reminds his disciples that they can't seek happiness the way the world does. True joy is not found in selfish ambition, excuses, or self-justification. An enviable state of blessedness comes to those who mourn over their own sin. These are the one I look on to favor. Those who are humble and contrite in spirit and who tremble at my word, Jesus said. When we agree with God about how bad our sin is, repent of it, and seek his power to walk away from it, Jesus' promises comfort from the Holy Spirit. The kind of mourning that leads to repentance is truly blessed. Repentance results in forgiveness and cleansing from God. When we have trusted in Jesus as our personal substitute for sin, we no longer stand condemned. Rather than wallow in guilt and shame, we realize that we can stand justified before God. Those who learn to mourn over their own sin find the heart of God. An intimate fellowship with God is the very foundation of that true happiness. I hope you found those useful. And I'd just like to finish with a prayer. So if you can just bow your head. Heavenly Father, help us by your Holy Spirit to understand the teaching of your Son, Jesus. Show us when we're being proud and being preoccupied with our need for self-importance rather than with your importance. Help us to be humble enough to admit our own faults and failings. Empty us of our selfishness and purify our motives. Enable us to see that the emptier we are, the more that you can fill us up with your beautiful attitudes. Bring true joy and happiness to us and those around us, we pray. And we ask these prayers in the precious name of Jesus. Thank you for listening.